Hey guys, welcome to my YouTube channel. And guys, in this video I'm talking about how to configure and troubleshoot DNS, and this is my 26th video in this series. I hope this video will be enough to understand the concept of DNS, how we can deploy a DNS server. In this we will understand lots of things. So first of all, I will tell you DNS is backbone for internet from the beginning, since the birth of technology of internet technology. Basically, without without DNS, internet, it seems almost nothing. You cannot work, you cannot do anything, you cannot access internet without DNS. Okay, so the basic function of DNS is name resolution, but apart from this there are a couple of other uses also we can use as per the requirement. If not required, you do not need to worry much about it, what is DNS and all. But if it is required, then you should know what and all we can do. So I will try to make it clear in this video, each and everything. Okay, so guys, first of all, in this video we are gonna learn a couple of things. We are going to do a couple of things, like we will configure DNS role, we will configure couple of zone. Okay, these are the zone name we will give, and I will tell you where and all why I have taken like this. Okay, and we will configure security, secondary zone, stub zone, zone transfer security, and these are required steps, you can say, to make a successful DNS configuration. Now I will give you the scenario. First of all, what I'm going to do, what we are going to understand in this video. So guys, first of all, you are a DNS administrator of India Bank. Okay, it is an example, you are administrator of India Bank. Now you got a you have received a request to create two DNS zones. So you have to create two DNS zone. The xyz.com zone is for the division in the bank that required its own DNS domain. So this is for XYZ, is for your internal domain kind of. Okay, and this division will also have a group of administrator that administer the zones resource record. So now you got a team of administrator who will be taking care of resources record modification, whatever it is. So they will be doing it. Now ABCD is a company that India Bank recently acquired. So this India Bank is one company, and they have purchased, or they have acquired one more company, which is ABCD.com or ABCD company by name. Okay, now you have to make integration between both the company, so that name resolution should happen. You can access resources from ABCD Bank, because that will be your existing infra. You will have to just integrate that with your India Bank infrastructure. Okay, to begin integration testing, you must define a DNS domain called abcd.com. So we will have to create domain. There should be a DNS domain. Obviously, if there is a company, so there will be like abcd.com or something like that, company what they are preferring. So it is a separate domain. And test different zones configuration. You also need to test the zone to ensure it is resilient of failure. So guys, in this video we are going to understand what is the part of india.com. okay, what and all we need to configure at India Bank company. Leave about ABCD, but same you will have to do at ABCD company also, or ABCD server also. Okay, so here these are the steps we need to follow. 11 steps, there are 11 steps. First of all, we will have to deploy one DNS server, then we will have to configure abcd.com zone, then xyz.com zone on DNS server on DC, then we will configure zone transfer, secondary zone, stub zone for india.com, and we will have to allow administrator account. Then we will test recursive query and simple query. We will verify SOA record by using NS lookup, and we will try to, you know, see what is the performance and verify the DNS application. So these are the 11 steps we will see in this video. And I'm using two computer here. One is my Active Directory, okay, and one is new server. I will deploy DNS on this server, and here we will create like xyz.com, secondary zone, primary zone, and the stub zone also, and here ABCD, because ABCD we have acquired. So this is my DNS server, so I want to give that role. This server should take care of all the zones and all. Okay, I hope this video will be informative, guys. And if you feel at the end it is informative, please don't forget to subscribe channel, comment in this video, share this video, and like this video. And don't forget to hit this bell button on your YouTube account on corner, so that you will get all the notifications. So let me begin with this here. So first of all, let me connect my virtual environment. So guys, here I have two machine here, okay, and this is my Active Directory. Binad india.com is my domain. I'm using same from long time on my lab environments. So as you can see here, okay, india.com is my domain and winad is name, and 254 is IP address. And here I have one more machine which I'm going to deploy as DNS server. Okay, you can see here, if you go to local server, so guys, here I have logged into my both machine. One is Active Directory and second is my server. As you can see here, this is just bare machine, and have this installed and added it to my domain, and the IP address is 252 for this, and win svr is svr1 is host name, and nothing is installed as of now. So first of all, you should install DNS role only. Just go to this. This is a fresh machine, okay, and select DNS server on this and click next. So it will ask for reboot and all. Just click next and click yes and install. Meanwhile, we need to create one group on our Active Directory. I told you we will have some administrator, DNS administrator. So for that, you can go to users and computers Active Directory, and here you can create one OU. Okay, so I'm creating one OU like India only, and India I gave, and just click OK. Now I'm creating one more OU inside this new OU, and I'm giving admins. Okay, so these are the admins who will be taking care of all the as per the requirement. So here I'm creating one group also inside that. Okay, so again I'm giving admins group, and it is a security groups. And now I will create one I want to, you know, copy my administrator account. Oh, here I should go administrator only. I want to create, so I'm just copying with that user only. So I'm giving DNS admin only. So you can have multiple users in this group. so that we will understand this, how to give permission and all. So I'm giving one password. Hit enter, and I will move this user to my, you know, like admin OU, and even I will make him member of this group, admin. Okay, so it is member of administrator as well as admin what we have created. Okay, successfully. Now the basic thing must, okay. Now we need to go to, so installation is succeeded. Now just close this. So we have done server installation. Now you need to go to DNS server, and you should configure one abcd.com zone. Okay, first of all on your WinSVR1 server. So let me go back here, and this is my server. Here I should create . So for this guys, you need to go to DNS manager, just click on DNS, and here you are on this, and you need to go to forward lookup zone and just right click and create new zone here. Just click next. You want to create primary zone, this one, just click next and give name. Name is like abcd.com I'm giving, okay. I give, just click next, and here what you need to select, like, you know, next here it is telling like create a new file with this file name, yes, and now it is telling whether you want to allow dynamic updates or not. So I don't want, I want, then just leave it default as it is and just click finish. So we have done, we have created one ABCD primary zone here on this forward lookup. Now next thing, we have to create one more same sort of zone on our Active Directory also. So there we will give name XYZ. So again you need to go to tools and DNS management, and here you can just right click and create new zone and give name primary only. Here you can define whether you want for forest or you want for domain. Okay, so we will go with this, like, you know, I want with this domain only. Okay, just click next here, and as you can see here, it will show you like Active Directory zone replication scope. So here you have to just go with domain only, or you can define forest also. So I'm just going with that only, and I'm giving name here. I'm giving name xyz.com, and just click next and finish it again. Allow, you can see, like, you know, default I'm taking here also. So I want like allow only secure updates, and just click finish. So we have done two steps, okay, out of this much we have done three. Now we will configure zone transfer. So for that, again we need to go to our server. For zone transfer, you need to go to DC here only and look up forward lookup zone, and what we have created, I want to create for this only. Okay, look up zone transfer security. So for this, you just need to go to property of this, what we have recently created, and here go to zone transfer. You can see this is zone transfer, and here you will have to see allow zone transfer. Okay, you are allowing, and now here you can see like only to the following servers. You can select from here, and you will have to click like, you know, edit and allow zone transfer. Here you will have to add that. So here give IP address of your secondary server 192.168.0.252. Secondary server, I am doing this on my Active Directory. Okay, so the thing is I want to transfer my zone from here to here. Replication should happen. That is the concept. And just click OK. Okay, so we have done this addition. And just click OK now. And now you have to, you know, click okay, apply and OK here, and just you need to go to secondary server. Here also you need to create same for your abcd.com. So you just right click here and go to property and just go to, you know, zone transfer. And here you need to select allow zone transfer only the following server here, and just click edit, and here you should give IP address of your primary server. Add IP address. So what happened? 192.168.0.254 is my primary Active Directory. Okay, and just click OK here. And now, as you can see here, you have to just move out from here and click OK and just apply and close it. So we have done zone security. So we have given here a specific zone only allowed on both the server. Okay, now we need to configure secondary zone. So we are done with this one. Zone transfer we have configured. Now we will configure secondary zone for each domain. So for this we need to go to once again and first go to your Active Directory. On Active Directory you should go to your forward lookup zone once again, and we are creating secondary zone now. Okay, so forward lookup, just click here and give secondary zone now and click next here, and here just give name once again abcd.com and click next, and here again you will have to assign IP address 192.168.0.252 of your secondary server because this is our Active Directory. And it is coming okay, and just click finish. Similarly you have to do here also on second server. Go to second server on abcd or here forward lookup zone, right click and give secondary server and click next, give here xyz.com, and this will be as 192.168.0.254 and just hit. So it is also okay and just click next, finish it. Now you have to configure a stub zone. So stub zone, if you want to configure, just click right click here, new zone, and now stub zone, and you select third option. And here, like again, you can give stub zone like india.com. I will have to give india.com specifically here. Okay, and just click next, and here next, and again give IP address of your primary server 192.168.0.252 and check validation. So it will be valid. Oh, sorry, 254 it should be. Okay, it is coming okay, and just finish it. Now you need to give, like, you know, administrator permissions, who can manage it and who can do what and all. So for that you need to go to your Active Directory main server, first server, and here you should go to, you know, forward lookup zone, then right click India. Here go to property once again, ABCD, and you have to go to property, and here you should see like, you know, security tab. It is not showing security tab. Zone transfer, this much only. Wait. We have to configure security on this. Okay, so you need to go to xyz.com, and here you can see security, and here you have to add the group what we have created, admin groups. So this group I want, and just click OK, and I can define here what I want, like, you know, like read write or create child object, delete all what and all I want. So I'm giving full access I'm giving, okay, and just apply it and click. We have created this for another domain, like another separate domain, other company. So we have to give access here what they can do. Now guys, we will do monitoring. So we are up to this, you know, let me show you. We have created a stub zone, we have configured you know, administrative options for XYZ domain here. Now we will test and see this recursive queries and what is happening. So for this I need to go to once again back to my server, and for this you need to go to DC and property, DC, and this is my, I'm at DC only, and now click property here of server only, okay, and here you can see couple of things, like, you know, monitoring most important here, and you should click like select simple query against this server, this one, okay, and just test now. So it is telling pass, configuration is successful. Now you check this one, test now. One is fail. So this recursive should come fail only. The reason is, like, you know, recursive, we'll see one by one. So this first, this simple query is coming fail. Okay, 1 minute. Simple query should come pass. Okay, the first one, and go down. Scroll down this one. Oh, let me reopen it. Monitoring here. I want to run this. So this is coming. Pass, okay. Oh, this is first one only. So this query came pass first. It should come fast, okay. Pass in first attempt only, and then I don't know why this much error is coming. And now we will understand why this fail is coming here for recursive. So it is coming pass, it is taking little bit time, okay. You should not feel like it is not working. And as you can see here, it is 10:04 timing. Just now we did this, and this recursive, if we check recursive, why it is coming fail. So guys, which is normal given that there are no forwarder configured on this, okay. So we will have to configure forwarder, then only it will come pass. So for this, what you need to do, you need to you know, go to run and cmd, type cmd, and here you can type sc stop dns and click enter. So as you can see here, you are getting couple of statistics is coming, like process is stopping status. Okay, you can possible, acceptable, shutdown. These are the status of DNS. Now go to monitoring and we will test both. So it should come fail now. Both should come fail. Even this recursive, this simple query should come fail because we have stopped this. Okay, even if you test one by one, it will come fail only. It will not come pass. It is simple query is coming fail and even recursive. Now you can check here, both coming fail. And if you restart this, it will come that at least one should come. Oh, start and just click DNS and start pending. And if you go to now, test now both. So here, simple query will be passed. It's little slow. It is coming pass. Okay. So now guys, we have tested all the queries and all. Now you just close this. Now we will see, like, you know, we will go for next step, further step. Just click OK and close this. And here, even this got failed because the DNS I had stopped. So you can from here you can restart it. Now we will go for next step, which is, you know, which is like we done this query testing. We will verify start of authority record by using NS lookup. So for this, what we need to do here, once again you need to go to your server, and here I'm just minimizing, go to DC once again, and command prompt. This is my command prompt here. Type NS lookup. NS lookup. Okay, this is run only, or I can go to run cmd NS lookup, and here you will have to type, like, you know, set query type. Okay, don't put any wrong spelling mistake here. I did, it seems. This query type and put equal start of authority and hit enter. Let's see. So as you can see here, it can't find the set non-existing, can't find server address. What is this now? So it is coming like can't find, and just type here and this lookup, type here xyz.com and hit enter. Is not recognized internal command, so put ns lookup and just hit.com. So it is, you can see it is telling you name here and it is giving address 127, like that. And here once again you type, we'll see, it should give valid name, basically it should not give this, and abcd.com. so here it is giving. I think we need to see what is, why it is coming from here, what is IP I have given here on my DNS. Okay, go to local server, and here IP version 4, and just go to this one and see. Okay, that is the IP it is showing because we have given here this IP. And if you want, you can change, like, you know, anything whichever you want, DNS and all. So I'm giving 888. Now if you go to this and type first command, so can't find server address, it is coming like that, but it is giving address. Okay, it is giving complete now. It is providing name. Earlier it was not providing. Even if you see this first one, there was nothing. It was there localhost. Just run NS lookup here. I'm just doing extra work here. So it is telling like giving you like, you know, as you can see here, Google what DNS we gave. Now put that query set query type equal s start of authority and hit enter. So it is it is done now. Okay, completely there is no error. And now type xyz.com. here we are setting up. Okay, so we did this. Don't put that first command what I gave like this. We will have to go like this. And it is telling you now that you can see here primary server is this and response for mail address this serial number refresh entry and all. This is called you know, record by verifying. And you can put same abcd.com once again. So for this also you will get certain you know, statistics here what and all is coming. So we have done this verification also. Okay, just be careful with the command, how to put, how to enter. Don't use like this. First run NS lookup command and then type set query type and all. Okay, don't make mistake and just close this. So now guys, next what we need to do, we have done almost all the steps here. Now we will view performance statistics by using performance console. Okay, so how to do it, I will show you here. That is second last step of this configuration. So for this you need to go to, you know, computer manager and diagnostics of your DC. So we are inside our Active Directory domain controller only. And here go to tools, computer management. Or you can go to, you know, just computer here, open this. And that is also same. Manage here. Okay, manage or this thing, same thing. Now you can go to, you know, diagnostics you need to find out. So if you go to this diagnostics, we can find out somewhere at this side. Is it possible? View. Windows memory diagnostics, we can find it out here. Restart, now check. Oh guys, let me pause this. I just restarted this. Okay, we'll continue once it is done. So guys, I have re-logged in. That was unnecessary restart. So here the last, you know, last option is like we have to perform, we have to check this performance. Okay, statistics, performance, what and all is coming. So for that you just need to go to performance monitor only. You do not need to go anywhere. Okay, that was some other stuff. You just go to this performance monitor here, go to performance monitor and from this monitoring tool and open it and just add here, go to this this symbol and find out the DNS here. You will find out definitely DNS option, local computer, somewhere it should be this DNS, and click here. Okay, scroll down and search total T. Total query received and just add it, and total query received per second, and just add this side and just click OK. Just leave it as it is. Oh sorry, just let me go back once again. DNS and just select those two. And add and leave it as it is. Okay, now what you need to do, as of now it is showing nothing. So for this, what we need to do, you need to go to, you know, DC. We are here only. We need to go to DNS management. Once again, we will go to that simple query and recursive query here, and monitoring tool property. Here you need to go to property and monitoring. And again, run this command and click test now again and again, again and again, couple of times. So it should give couple of statistics. So both queries pass now, that recursive as well as this. Okay, there is no issue in this. So just click text next. Why it is coming? Because we have done that DNS, you know, do you remember? SO record, start of authority record, that is why recursive query is working now properly. Earlier it was giving some error, it was not working. So you should verify all those things at the end of this configuration. Everything should work properly. Okay, now we will go to this performance monitor only. We'll see if we can see any changes here. So you just click this, okay, one or more selected counter are already present, okay. So here, this is what we can see in graph, like something it is telling. So just refresh it if possible. So here, as you can see here, okay, received queries statistics will come here and here also. So it is not giving because I think we have not given any load on this. Here some statistics should come. Or we should run one more command here. Let me show you here, like, you know, go to CMD and do that is also use verification name like DNS LINT and slash S, then give 192.168.0.254 and now put D in here xyz.com, okay, and hit enter. DNS lint command is not recognized. Or just let me put this only. Not recognize DNS lint. Okay, leave it. So here just you can see couple of you know this thing statistics it should reflect 252. Let me ping or if I copy something from this server to this server, or from here if I take something nothing is coming to me. Let me copy all the folder only. Here I should copy, sir. Bindu R. For example, I have some data here, so let me copy some data from here. To this drive only. So is it changing something? No, it's still not changing. Just press Control G. So guys, if you have heavy traffic, definitely here it will show you some sort of, you know, data, like in green how much it is retrieving or something like that. So there is no huge traffic, that is why it is not coming, anything is not showing to me. But this is how you can see, you can monitor all the stuff. Okay, or if you put local computer this time, I'm going once again. DNS local computer. No, only this queries. Add. Okay. Yes. So this PC is local only. Okay, so it should show that graph here, whatever is coming going here and there. So let me go to DNS once again and close that queries and all what is running here. So let me remove. I will give one more time. And just finish it. So you go to server manager once and Control G. So guys, I'm just finishing this here. Definitely it will come if traffic is there, definitely you will get here. Okay, I spent so much time on this. Now we'll see one replication of this video, replication is happening or not. So if I make any change on you know, at my primary, it should reflect to both the server. Okay, so we will create one SO record, any record, and we'll see. So for this you need to go to, you know, forward lookup zone of your DNS here only, and create one record here, XYZ. I want to create here an A record, like I'm giving, you know, I'm giving test and just give IP address 192.168.0.250 for this, or 250, and click add host and OK. And now we'll verify this on this server. Just go to login and check DNS. What is this? Okay, just refresh this DNS and go to xyz.com. So that record should come here. So let me go to this, done. We have created this and just refresh this. It should replicate it automatically. If not, then we can, you know, transfer it from here. Just right click and go to property, zone transfer. Click OK. So let me check why it is not coming. It should come. That is the only verification pending of this video. So guys, if it is not reflecting here, you can, what you can do, like, you know, on your primary server, you can go and just click refresh this. And apart from this, now what you can do, you can go to your secondary server, even you can refresh this and like this. And if still is not coming, then you just go to this option and transfer from master and just refresh it once again. So as you can see here, it came now that host automatically. So this is the troubleshooting. You should know if it is not reflecting, how we can do it. So guys, in this video, I'm done with all the configuration of DNS. The application is happening. We created a couple of zones. I created XYZ this side, all is replicating on both the server. Okay, three here, three this side, and all the testing is happening, except that counter performance is not coming, but it will come if some heavy load is there, definitely come. So I hope this video will be informative to understand. Similarly guys, this is what india.com I have. Okay, india.com is my domain I had. For example, if you have I told you, I had told you, 1 minute, I will show you. where is this gone now? See, I had told you in this scenario, India.com company has purchased or acquired ABCD. So same sort of configuration, whichever is required, you will have to do on this server also, ABCD company server. Then it will become a complete configuration. We have done it at India Bank, what and all we have to do. So I hope this video will be informative to clear your, you know, all the concept here. And thanks for watching for this video, and try to implement, and don't forget to hit like, share and comment. And I'm sure only one thing I am missing here, that was that performance. And I'm sure if any traffic is there, definitely it will work for you guys. So guys, till then, bye bye, have a nice time. Thanks for watching for this video, and wait for my next video. And next video will be talking about something, some other useful topic. So till then, bye bye.